Here it comes! Boom shakalaka!
Hi! For those who don't know me, my name is Vavo, and this is a YouTube channel called Boom Shakalaka. And here I talk about NBA and basketball in Portuguese. Well, this is the 418th video on the channel, and for the first time I'm speaking in English. It is an experience, of course. I want to see if I can reach a larger audience abroad and not just in Portuguese-speaking countries like Brazil, Portugal, Angola, Mozambique, etc. And for the first video in English, I decided to re-record a video I released in October 2018 with the 15 tallest players in NBA history. In fact, that original video had only 14 players because one of them, and you should know who it is, just joined the league this last season. So in addition to a new version, it is also an update. Enjoy it. In the 15th place with 7'3.5", the center from Puerto Rico, Peter John Ramos. He played just 6 games for the Washington Wizards during the 04-05 season when he was only 19 years old. Today, Ramos is 35 and is still playing for a team called Leones de Ponce in his birth country. He also was a member of the Puerto Rico national basketball team from 2004 to 2016, making his Olympic debut in the game where Puerto Rico defeated Team USA at Athens. Now we have a tie between 5 players in the 10th place, all of them 7'4" high. Let's begin with the fan favorite Boban Marjanovic, who is a current player for the Dallas Mavericks. In the Portuguese version of this video released 2 years ago, Marjanovic was officially listed with 7'3.5". However, with the new official measurements conducted by the league last offseason, Boban grew half an inch. Now he's officially a 7'4". He is now 32 years old and had a relevant role in Dallas's rotation in the last playoff run. Also with 7'4", big man Priest Lauderdale. Priest was selected by the Atlanta Hawks in the 1996 NBA draft in the 28th overall pick. He played 35 games for the Hawks in his first season, then 39 more games for the Nuggets in his second season, and that's his career in the NBA. After that, he played overseas for a few years and then retired in 2011. Mark Eaton was a big impact center that played 875 games for the Jazz between 1982 and 1993. He was an All-Star once in 1989. In the 84-85 season, he blocked 456 shots, becoming the first and only player in NBA history to surpass the 400 blocks per year. He has also the record for most blocks per game in a career with 3.5, and he will probably stay on the top of this ranking forever. The fourth 7'4 is the first overall pick in the 1983 NBA draft, Rolf Sampson. Sampson had unusual skills for someone of his height, and it was even expected for him to be one of the greatest players of all time. His first 4 seasons were awesome, he was an all-star in all of them, he won the Rookie of the Year award, and he reached the NBA Finals with the Houston Rockets in his 3rd season. Nonetheless, he suffered critical injuries that shortened his career to less than 500 games in 9 seasons. And last but not least, the 5th 7'4 is the franchise center for the Indiana Pacers, Rick Smits. He played for 12 seasons in the NBA, all of them for the Pacers, playing one All-Star game in 1998 when he was 31 years old. In his last season, 1999-2000, Smits reached the NBA Finals when the Pacers were defeated by Kobe and Shaq Los Angeles Lakers. Now we have another tie with 3 players sharing the 7th place with 7'5". With many comings and goings in the league during the 80s and 90s, Chuck Navitt played a total of 9 seasons with 5 different teams: Rockets, Lakers, Pistons, Bulls and Spurs. Navitt never once was in the spotlight and averaged just 1.6 point and 1.5 rebound in his career. It's worth mentioning that Navitt is the tallest American player ever in the NBA. The second player with 7'5" is Pavel Podkolzin. He played for the Mavericks only 2 seasons between 2004 and 2006, with just 6 total games played. In the 6 games, he scored only 4 points, all of them in free throws, grabbed 9 rebounds and blocked 1 shot. And now from Senegal, Taco Fall! Another fan favorite. In the 2019 official measurement, with no shoes, Taco was listed as a 7'5". He just played his first season with the Boston Celtics, reaching the conference finals when they were defeated by the Miami Heat. However, he had a really small role in the team's rotation during the playoffs. He played 3 minutes in a game against Philly and another fateful 0.5 seconds right before OG Anunoby's buzzer-beater game winner. The sixth place on the list goes to the only Indian descendant to ever play in the NBA, Sim Bular. Bular is 7 feet 5 inches and a half tall. In the 2014-15 season, he played 3 games for the Sacramento Kings, scoring a total of 2 points. Today, Bular plays in the Super Basketball League in Taiwan. Three players share the third place on the list with 7 foot 6. I'm going from the least known to the most known. Slavko Vranješ is a Montenegrin player who played 3 minutes of a game for the Blazers in the 03-04 season, the game from which I took these photos that are on the screen, obviously. Today he is 37 and he has retired in 2018 after playing his final season in the Serbian League. Sean Bradley was a great prospect from college who was selected in the second overall pick in the 1993 NBA draft by the Philadelphia 76ers. He played for 12 seasons and a total of 832 games. In the 96-97 season, he led the NBA in blocks per game with 3.4. And he had one of the most unbelievable triple-doubles in NBA history. 22 points, 22 rebounds and 13 blocks coming from the bench. He had 6 triple-doubles in his career, all of them with points, rebounds and blocks. And he was a monster on Space Jam 2. The third 7'6 player is the only Hall of Famer on this list, the Wall of China Yao Ming. Yao was the first pick overall in the 2002 NBA draft, selected by the Houston Rockets, and he played for the franchise from 2002 to 2011, being an All-Star 8 times. Yao's role goes far beyond the basketball court. He was, and still is, an ambassador for Chinese basketball in the United States and worldwide, and he is also the current president of the Chinese Basketball Association. And he has his jersey number 11 retired by the Houston Rockets too. The second tallest NBA player of all time is the South Sudanese Manute Bol with 7 feet 6 inches and 3 quarters of an inch. This is the official height measurement made by the Guinness Book of Records. Bol has played 10 seasons in the NBA for 4 different teams, and he's the only player in NBA history to have more blocks than points scored in a career. He led the league in blocks per game twice, in his debut season with 5 blocks per game, and later in the 88-89 season with 4.3. Manute Bol passed away in 2010, and his son, Bol Bol, is a current player for the Denver Nuggets. Fun fact! Manute Bol played alongside the shortest player in the NBA history, Muggsy Bogues, during the 87-88 season for the Washington Bullets. Their difference in height was 28 inches, 71 centimeters. And now, the first place. The tallest player in NBA history is the Romanian George Mirezan with 7 feet 7 inches, just like his jersey is showing to us. Mirezan played in the NBA in 6 different seasons, and he is the only player in this list with an individual award. He was the most improved player in the 95-96 season, improving his averages from 5 points and 3 boards to 15 points and 10 boards. Like most of the very tall players, Mirezan had many injuries and his career was cut short. Fun fact, Mirezan played a character in the 1998 movie My Giant with Billy Crystal. And that's it. If you are new to the channel, I hope you enjoyed it. Soon I will make more videos in English. Subscribe if you want to. If you want to follow me on Instagram, it's BoomShakaLand. If you want to follow me on Twitch, it's BoomShakaLive. Yeah, I am very creative. Thanks for the audience. See you next time.